Let's look at an example of a z-test for the population mean mu. A producer of cereal is producing boxes of cereal with a stated weight of 750 grams. It is known from a large body of past experience that the standard deviation of the weights in their filling process is approximately 16 grams, or in other words, the true population standard deviation is known to be approximately 16 grams. In order to ensure that not many boxes are underfilled, the producer sets the mean fill amount at 780 grams. As part of the quality control process, they periodically draw a random sample of 25 boxes, measure the weights, and test the null hypothesis that the mean fill amount is 780 grams. In other words, they test the null hypothesis that mu, representing the true mean fill amount, is 780. And since they care about a difference in either direction, we are going to use a two-sided alternative. They want it to equal 780, so the alternative hypothesis is going to be that it's different from 780. And suppose for the sake of argument that they feel an alpha level of 0.05 is reasonable for this test. In a sample of 25 boxes, the sample mean was found to be 776 grams. Does this give strong evidence the true mean weight differs from 780 grams? Is this 776 grams significantly different from 780? Let's summarize the information we have to this point. We're testing the null hypothesis that the true mean is 780 grams against a two-sided alternative at an alpha level of 0.05. The observed value of the sample mean is 776 grams, the population standard deviation sigma is known to be 16, and we had a sample size of 25. Since the population standard deviation is known here, we're going to be able to use a z-test, provided the normality assumption of the z-test is reasonable. So let's plot our data and have a look. Here's a box plot of the cereal weights for the 25 boxes, and I've plotted in a red line representing the hypothesized value of 780 grams. The sample mean was found to be 776 grams, and we want to see if that difference is a significant difference. It doesn't look like a big difference, but we can't tell whether that is a significant difference until we carry out the test. The z-test assumes that we are sampling from a normally distributed population. And we should investigate this assumption by plotting a normal quantile-quantile plot of our observed data values. Here's a normal quantile-quantile plot of the weights in the 25 boxes of cereal. Since the dots fall on an approximately straight line, we can say that our sample data is approximately normally distributed. So I'm going to give this the big check mark and say that it's okay to go ahead with our test. We might see this z-test statistic written in one of two ways. Sigma x bar is just sigma over the square root of n. If we want the value of this test statistic, we take the sample mean, 776, we subtract the hypothesized value from the null hypothesis, which is 780, divide by sigma, which is 16, over the square root of the sample size of 25. This works out to minus 1.25. Now we need to get the p-value. First, we draw out the standard normal distribution, which is the distribution of this z-test statistic if the null hypothesis is true. And I put in 0 here for a little perspective. Our observed value of our test statistic is over here somewhere at minus 1.25. Here the alternative hypothesis is two-sided, so to get our p-value, we take the tail area out beyond the test statistic and double it. If we go to software or the standard normal table, we can find that this area is 0.1056. And so our p-value is 2 times that quantity, 2 times 0.1056, which is and I'm going to round to three decimal places here, 0.211. We can say that the evidence against the null hypothesis is significant if the p-value is less than or equal to the given value of alpha. But our p-value of 0.211 is greater than the given alpha level. And so the evidence against the null hypothesis is not significant at an alpha level of 0.05. We do not have significant evidence that the population mean differs from 780 grams. Even if we did not have a given alpha level, we should still be able to come up with a reasonable conclusion based on the p-value. Here the p-value of 0.211 is not very small. And so we could say something like, with a p-value of 0.211, there is little or no evidence that the true mean weight of the filling process differs from 780 grams. Note that this does not imply there is strong evidence that the mean is actually equal to 780 grams. We simply do not have strong evidence that it's different from 780 grams.